I don't wanna say goodbye, cause this one means forever.
Well, what do you know? I guess I'll be the one who dies first.
There literally are too many jokes going on.
Yeah. We're pretending the lens is baby. Okay.
My house has a nice view because, you know, I was on Friends. And at one point in London, somebody forgot their lines and we were silent on stage for 15 seconds. And I didn't know what to say, the actress didn't know what to say, and the way I chose to deal with the situation is I just turned out to the audience and just went, what the hell's happening?
We're both very competitive. In fact, I think during this interview, I'm winning 4-2. So far.
Quickly, let's do new words for different fruits.
Okay.
Then. All right. What about this one?
Oh, that's a romope.
A pointy pointy.
Oh, no, no, no. No.
A pointy pointy.
So where are the rest of the friends?
The rest of Maddie is in New York. They're all out of town, which is too bad. But we get to keep the awards, so the hell with them.
Can't say those words in America on TV.
No.
You can't say fuck on...
Yes.
Well, I'm really enjoying it.
Yes! It's a bit nice.
Really,
it's
fun
it's
to
liberating.
Say.
It's liberating.
Yeah. It's a good word.
Yeah.
Why did you decide to share your story in ways you never have before? Nothing close to this.
Yeah, I mean, much like Mariah Carey, it's just time.
But I think all of you guys are hilarious every time. Well, why did I suck so much?
That's the neurosis. That's why we're all not plumbers. That's
right.
Why we're actors and neurotic and needy.
Yeah.
Huh.
Courtney and I are sort of like a married couple without all the, you know, the fights or unfortunately the, you know, the sex,
yeah.
The goods, as she puts it.
On behalf of everyone involved in the show,
I love you too, Matt.
So I thought this could be really fun, you know, this could be exciting. This is brand new. It reminded me of the night that I won my first Emmy. The magical night. I'm sorry? Oh, I haven't won a damn thing. That's right. I forgot.
Quiet down back there!
Okay, you were all right. The line sucked.
What the hell's happening?
This is Friends, right?
Apparently we don't need actors.
Ow! Can somebody teach Matt how to use a door?
Okay.
Read your script.
Nice!
X-Camera, you good?
Well, you're not taking it very well.
Chandler, we said we would meet at the coffee house at 6.
We said 7, you dumb whore bag.
He thinks I'm a slut.
Have you looked in the mirror?
Was any of it right?
But you look great.
Thank you.
Sure, and then you could get a little Diane, don't write the word on my little piece of paper.
I'm hopeless and awkward and desperate for love.
I'm Chandler. I make jokes when I'm uncomfortable. You did look like an idiot.
I'm not great at the advice. Can I interest you in a sarcastic comment?
She would walk in, I'd be like, hey, good to see you. And I'd go to my dressing room and just go, oh, I'll never be able to be with her.
I wanna take you somewhere, you know I care, but it's so cold and I don't know where.
Man, next time to get in here, I'll have to buy a ticket. Can't you give me 5?
The best way that I can describe it is after the show was over at a party or any kind of social gathering, if one of us bumped into each other, that was it. That was the end of the night. You just
sat with
the person all night long.
I remember that.
And that was it. You apologized to the people you were with, but they had to understand you had met somebody special to you and you were going to talk to that person for the rest of the night. And that's the way...
I'm crying because it's so true.
That's the way it worked.
Mm-hmm.
It's certainly the way it works with all of us. It's just the way it is. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna cry now.
Good.
I've got a piece of a Kleenex.
No, thanks, I'll take it.
It's been COVID tested.
Thank you, I'll take it. COVID tested?
COVID tested.
I'm not gonna miss you helping me out with money. The only thing that I'm gonna miss is you.
This is harder than I thought it would be.
I don't wanna say goodbye, cause this one means forever. Now you're in the stars, and 6 feet never felt so far. Here I am alone between the heavens and the earth.
It's so quiet here, and I feel so cold.
Day the music died and they were singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry, and them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing this'll be the day that I die.
Let me just say something, because once we get into this, I'm gonna get all uncomfortable and probably make some stupid joke. I just want to say that I love you, and I'm gonna miss you, and I'm so sad that you're leaving.
Oh, you know what? Let's not say anything else. I love you.
The only traveler who was not prepared to stay. I've been searching for a trail to follow again. Take me by.
And I can still see it all in my mind. All of you, all of me intertwined. Believe love would be black and white, but it's golden. And I can still see it all in my head, back and forth from New York, sneaking in your bed. I once believed love would be burning red, but it's golden.
What doesn't Matthew know?
That he's all right. We didn't know. We, you know, we weren't equipped. We weren't to deal with it. You know, nobody had ever dealt with that. And, you know, the idea of even losing him or...
No, I guess I'll be the one who dies first. I'm gonna die alone.
Wait, this picture is supposed to say Gellerin being to be married, not local woman saves drowning moron.
Matthew Perry is so funny. And the minute I set eyes on him and he opened his mouth, I thought, oh God, I'm gonna lose it. I'm gonna crack up. This character needs a laugh because I'm not gonna be able to get through a single scene with this guy. And I just looked at him and I went, ah! And that was it.
Thank you, Matthew, for inspiring that.
Goodbye, goodbye. You are bigger than the whole sky.
Though I have to
say goodbye, remember me. Don't let it make you cry, for even if I'm far away, I hold you in my heart. I sing a secret song to you each night we are apart.
Chandler stole a 20 from my purse!
You know what? Now that I think about it, I constantly find myself without 20s, and you always have lots.
When I die, I don't want friends to be the first thing that's mentioned. I want that to be the first thing that's mentioned. And I'm going to live the rest of my life proving that. I would like to be remembered as somebody who lived well, loved well, was a seeker. His paramount thing is that he wants to help people.